Welcome to this tutorial on roots of polynomials. In this tutorial, we will learn to plot graphs of polynomial equations, about complex numbers, real and imaginary roots, to find extrema and inflection points. To follow this tutorial, you should be familiar with GeoGebra interface, basics of coordinate system, polynomials. If not, for relevant tutorials, please visit our website. Here, I am using Ubuntu Linux operating system version 14.04, GeoGebra 5.0.388.0-D. Let us begin with the binomial theorem. A and B are real numbers. Index n is a positive integer. R lies between 0 and n. Binomial theorem states that a plus b raised to n can be expanded as shown. Quadratic equations and roots. A second degree polynomial y equals ax squared plus bx plus c has roots given by values of x. X is equal to ratio of minus b plus or minus square root of b squared minus 4ac to 2a, where discriminant delta is equal to b squared minus 4ac. When delta is less than 0, roots are complex. When delta is equal to 0, roots are real and equal. When delta is greater than 0, roots are real and unequal. When roots are real, ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0 has extremum xv, yv. xv equals minus b divided by 2a and yv equals axv squared plus bxv plus c. I have already opened the GeoGebra interface. Click on View tool and select CAS to open the CAS view. In line 1 in CAS view, type the following line. F x in parenthesis colon equals x caret 2 minus 2 space x minus 3. To type caret symbol, hold shift key down and press 6. The space indicates multiplication. Press enter. Drag boundary to see algebra view properly. Observe the equation f of x in algebra view. The degree of this quadratic polynomial f of x is 2. Drag boundary to see graphics view properly. Click in graphics view to see graphics view toolbar. Under Move graphics view, click on Zoom out tool. Click in graphics view to see the minimum vertex of parabola F. Click on Move graphics view tool and click in graphics background. When hand symbol appears, drag graphics view so you can see parabola F. Drag boundaries to see CAS view properly. In line 2 of CAS view, type root f in parenthesis, press enter. The roots appear below in the same box in curly brackets. Note that these are the x-intercepts of parabola f in graphics view. In line 3 of CAS view, type extremum f in parenthesis, press enter. The extremum appears below in the same box in curly brackets. Note that this is the minimum vertex of parabola f in graphics view. In line 4 in CAS view, type the following line. G x in parenthesis colon equals x caret 2 plus 5 space x plus 10. Press enter. Drag boundary to see algebra view properly. Observe the equation g of x in algebra view. Drag boundary to see graphics view properly. Uncheck f of x in CAS view. Note that this also unchecks it in algebra view and hides parabola f in graphics view. Click in and drag graphics view so you can see parabola g. Again, drag boundary to see CAS view properly. In line 5 of CAS view, type root g in parenthesis. Press enter. Empty curly brackets appear below. Parabola g does not have any real roots as it does not intersect x-axis at all. Roots are said to be complex. In line 6 of CAS view, type extremum g in parenthesis, press enter. The extremum appears below in the same box in curly brackets. Note that this is the minimum vertex of parabola g in graphics view. While evaluate tool is highlighted in CAS view toolbar, the extremum appears as fractions. Minus 5 divided by 2, comma 15 divided by 4. In line 6, click on the extremum and click on numeric tool. The extremum now appears in decimal form. Minus 2.5, comma 3.75. Let us look at complex numbers. Complex numbers, xy plane. A complex number is expressed as z equals a plus bi. A is the real part, bi is imaginary part, a and b are constants. I is imaginary number and is equal to square root of minus 1. In the xy plane, a plus bi corresponds to the point a comma b. In the complex plane, x-axis is called real axis, y-axis is called imaginary axis. Complex numbers, complex plane. In complex plane, z is a vector. Its real axis coordinate is a and imaginary axis coordinate is b. The length of the vector z is equal to the absolute value of z and to r. According to Pythagoras' theorem, r is equal to square root of a squared plus b squared. Let us go back to the GeoGebra interface we were working on. We will now use the input bar instead of CAS view. Click and close CAS view. In algebra view, uncheck g of x to hide it. In input bar, type the following line. H x in parenthesis colon equals x caret 3 minus 4 space x caret 2 plus x plus 6. Press enter. Drag boundaries to see algebra and graphics views properly. Observe equation h of x in algebra view. Function h of x is graphed in graphics view. Under Move Graphics View, click on Zoom Out tool, click in Graphics View, click on Move Graphics View, and Move Graphics Background to see the graph. In input bar, type root h in parenthesis and press enter. The coordinates of three roots A, B and C appear in algebra view. The three roots are also mapped as x-intercepts of the curve h of x in graphics view. In input bar, type extremum h in parenthesis and press enter. Coordinates of two extrema, D and E, appear in algebra view. The two extrema are also mapped on curve h of x in graphics view. Point of inflection. A point of inflection, POI, on a curve is the point where the curve changes its direction. To find the coordinates of POI, x, y, we equate second derivative of the given function to 0. Solution of this equation gives us x, x coordinate of POI. Substitute this x in original function to get y coordinate. Let us find the point of inflection on h of x. In input bar, type INF and scroll down menu to choose inflection point polynomial option. Instead of highlighted polynomial, type H and press enter. In algebra view, point of inflection appears as point F below the two extrema. F is mapped on h of x in graphics view. Correlate the degree of the polynomials and the number of roots seen so far. Observe that functions entered in CAS appear in algebra and graphics views. Functions entered in input bar appear in algebra and graphics views, but not in CAS view. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we have learnt to plot graphs of polynomial functions using CAS view and input bar. Find real roots, extrema, and inflection points. Complex roots will be covered in another tutorial. Assignment: plot graphs and find roots, extrema, and inflection points for the following polynomials. The video at the following link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. The spoken tutorial project team conducts workshops and gives certificates. For more details, please write to us. Please post your timed queries on this forum. Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by NMEICT, MHRD, Government of India. More information on this mission is available at this link. This is Vidya Iyer from IIT Bombay, signing off. Thank you for joining.